So 10 minutes, and then 8 minutes, or 2 minute warning, and then 5 questions.
All right. Hello, my name is Jay Richardson, and I did my RD on altimeter temperature. And one of the main reasons I did this, or the reason for doing this was because I was seeing if altimeters and their temperature affected the reading of that altimeter gave. And the whole reason I started doing that is because for one of my NARAMs, I did a previous R&D, and it involved having altimeters, and I launched a certain number of control flights and got an altitude, and I had a predicted scale event, or a predicted altitude event. So I launched it, and I got lower, and it was hot and cold, there was different weather. I approached this using two identical rockets to warm up the altimeter. I laid it on the concrete, got it up in the sun to got it up to 100 degrees. So it was hot outside, sunny. To cool it down, I put it in a vacuum sealed freezer bag. I put it in the fridge to cool it down. These are the launches. Data. Averages are in the end. This is a graph showing how they varied from launch to launch. My conclusion to this was that altimeters have, if they're different temperatures, they have different readings. And even though the cold one had higher readings, it still varied a lot differently. And you could get lower readings as the hot ones stayed more consistent.
Measuring the temperature of the altimeters, how were you measuring them?
I was using an infrared laser gun, and it had a little laser pointer on it. You could point out what you're measuring.
And which part of the altimeter were you aiming at?
Right on the top, right where the little light is. So the altimeter has a blinking light, so aim it right on top of it.
Okay.
Good.
Okay, so how long did it take between when you pulled off your altimeter and then you had to go put it in your rocket and then go fly it?
I had my rocket ready and prepped, put the engine in it and everything, and I put it in there and I sealed the top and I went out and launched it as quick as possible.
And how much do you think it cooled down or warmed up during that little bit of time?
I didn't ever measure it, but I think it was a lot, because I know some of my launches I might have taken a little bit longer than the other one, so, yeah.
And then go back to your graphs, because the colors are not showing up too well on your screen. So on the left are all these red.
Yeah, on the left they're all red. And
that means those are the hot ones.
Yes, and the purple ones, don't know how they got purple.
They're kind of like darker red to me. Yeah. Okay, yeah.
Those are supposed to be the cold ones, and on the end you have a red one and a purple one. Those are the averages.
So basically, do you see any difference between the red and the purple ones?
I see it more varied than the purple ones, and how it kind of jumps around.
Yeah, and do you see that the purple ones look like on average they went higher?
They did go higher, but there was some of them where they went a little bit lower than the average of the hot one.
So do you think that there was no difference really between the average, essentially?
I think if you were able to get a good flight on altitude with a cold one or something like that, that you might get a higher altitude, but at the same time you might get a lower one. So it's kind of iffy if you would want to stay with the hot one or go with the cold.
So if you go to the next slide, what is this showing you? Pretty much the same thing?
Yes, it's showing from launch to launch how It shows a hot one, how it's kind of just like a little hill, and it shows how it's mountains on the cold one, how it just jumped.
The Jaggy one's the purple, the smoother one's the red.
So you see the variance, the cold one, you're getting a lot of difference in the altitude, and the hot one, you're getting kind of almost a constant. So what do you think that means about your hypothesis? You had some memory that hot and cold altimeters performed, you thought they performed better or worse. So what made you think that initially? Was it a bunch of flights you did one day, or?
I had an R&D for a previous NARAM, and I was testing aerodynamics. So I had a control rocket. I ended up using that same rocket for a competition at NARAM, which was predicted altitude. And when I did my R&D, it was overcast. It was cool weather and kind of chilly outside. But at the NARAM, it was hot. It was sunny. So I said, hey, you know, maybe I can try it some year for my R&D or something.
Do you think that air pressure may be more of an effect, or the temperature outside may be more of an effect on how high the rocket goes?
Density, basically, or like
Density. Yeah.
That could be it. There's a lot of variables like wind, and then sometimes the motors are made a little bit differently. There's a lot of variables, and for my further research, I actually wanted to test them in a vacuum chamber so I can get the same kind of lift every single time instead of having all those variables.
Okay.
Just following up on one of Joyce's questions, when you did your flight trials, did you record the outside air temperature as well so that you could look to see if maybe it was the air temperature rather than the sensor temperature whether that was affecting it? It sounds as though you haven't crunched the numbers, but did you at least record the data so you could go back and do that?
I didn't record the temperature outside, but I knew towards the morning it would be cooler, so I launched most of my cold ones first, and towards the afternoon I started launching my hot ones.
That might be if you're still doing flight tests versus altitude chamber, that might be something to consider as well, because it's programmed into contest manager now. That's the fact you've got to enter the air temperature when you're doing altitude flights, or will in the next version. We're going to be correcting. We're going to have to, for competition now, for altimeter events, they're going to have to enter temperature correction, so that might be something worth exploring as a follow-up project.
Thank you.
Have you applied any of this knowledge this week? Have you been keeping your altimeters in your ice chest?
No,
putting them out on a hot brick or anything?
I haven't read the big book. I don't know any of the rules. I wouldn't want to.
All right.
Good boy.
This integrity stuff is concerning.
It's not a rule against it. You know? Yeah.
It's ethics.
But yeah, sportsmanship in care applies.
Yes.
Okay, does the audience have some questions? Go ahead.
My big question is, did you fly the hot and cold altimeter in the same rocket each time? Meaning, did you launch them both at the same time in one model?
No. I actually had two different ones, and halfway through I switched the altimeters. So I could rule out that it was the altimeters just messing up.
So each and every data point is a different motor?
Yes. I launched them each 10 times to get more of a broad.
In the future, you might want to consider a model with a large enough bay to put both the hot and the cold in the same model, the same flight. That would remove the motor as a variable.
Yeah, okay, got two more
there.
Go ahead, guy in front there.
Yeah, follow up on that. If you zero out the altimeter in a hot environment and then move it to a cold environment, does it register an altitude shift? It'd be neat to take the model kind of out of the equation, the variability of the motors and that, to see just what is the accuracy of the functional temperature.
That was for the further research. I was going to do it in a vacuum chamber.
Yeah.
Kind of get the same kind of...
Yeah.
You clearly demonstrated the variability among altimeters as a function of temperature. Do you think that you can find a temperature at which the line is flat?
I have not tested them at an ambient temperature. I tested them as hot or cold. I didn't deem a control rocket necessary, being that I was testing high temperature versus low temperature.
I'm sorry, but based on your presentation, I'm not sure. Did you use more than one model altimeter?
I just used the same altimeter. It was the same type.
I had just one more question. Did you weigh your rocket each time you flew to make sure it didn't change weight?
I didn't weigh them, but I built them out of the same rocket kit, and after each launch, I lightly sanded the inside to get all the ejection charring and all that other stuff out, make sure they were the closest weight as possible.
Were the two rockets the same weight?
I don't know, but they were...
You never weighed them?
Yeah, pretty sure they would be pretty close. I also did switch to altimeters, so that might
have been... Yeah, right, so you switched to all right, any more questions? All right, thank you very much.